Thank you to MOMI, and thank you to the Japan Society for holding this amazing event. Has everyone seen how incredible everyone looks? It's like unbelievable. Before we begin tonight's panel, I'd like to introduce the rest of the people here. Our first panelist is Misako Aoki. She has served as top model for Baby the Star Shine Bright, Putumayo, Algonquins, and other well-known Japanese Gothic and Lolita fashion brands. She's also graced the pages of the leading Harajuku magazine, Kara. Her role as the official Kawaii Ambassador for the Japanese government, she traveled the world to help and develop appreciation of Japanese fashion and pop culture. She is also president of the Japan Lolita Association, which was established in 2013. Our next panelist is Carolyn Dee, who has been involved with Lolita fashion for over a decade and runs the popular Lolita blog, F Yeah Lolita. Yeah. She is also the administrator of the largest English-speaking Lolita online community and is co-creator of RuffleCon, the first Northeast USA alternative fashion conference. And our final panelist is Christina Gleason, who has been a longtime researcher of Lolita fashion and its subculture throughout with various surveys and interviews on her blog, Ramble Rori. She's also a co-creator of RuffleCon. So without further ado, please give a huge welcome to our panelists. Hi, everybody.
Hi.
So first, I want to ask, what is everyone wearing? What are you wearing?
I'm wearing a dress from our baby, of course, and it has a ballroom motif, and it's got a bit of a princess look, and the princess sleeves is what I like the most.
Beautiful.
I'm wearing Baby the Star Shine Bright, Baby the Star Shine Bright, and a lot of mint and white.
I love it.
I'm wearing a 2004 Innocent World piano piece and some off-brand stuff.
The details on that are amazing.
Yes,
I don't know
pleated.
If you guys can see. All the piano keys are pleated. This is something that I really love about Lolita fashion, which I don't really know anything about, which I'm going to learn tonight. Is the attention to detail. There's so much elaborate detail in everything. The lace, the ruffle, the pleats, amazing. But I know that there's a lot of different kinds of styles of Lolita. Like, what are the styles? Where does that come from? And do you guys have preferred styles in the fashion? Anybody.
There's like the three big styles are considered classic, sweet, and gothic, but there's a lot of overlap, and no one's really one particular style most of the time. My favorite is like a combination of gothic and classic.
I know that I am wearing over-the-top sweet Lolita, which I can't get enough of.
I know,
it's so much fun. Do you have a specific style of Lolita that you prefer?
Pink is my favorite color. So I like the Ama Lolita or the Sweet Lolita, that's my favorite. But I love all genres and all styles. I tend to combine a lot of them.
I also know, this is like my fact sheet of like the four things I know about Lolita. I also know that Lolita fashion, at least the garment construction is inspired by a Victorian and Rococo era, Marie Antoinette, kind of aristocracy, and it's on a lot of the prints. Like, I don't know if you guys can see this, but her dress has like pretty maidens and Victorian dresses dancing with what I'm assuming are handsome princes. So what is it? I know that it's also associated with Lita is, tea parties, garden parties, baking. Is this Is this like more of a way to express femininity, or what is what do you feel?
Personally, I feel that all those things can be Lolita, but there's lots of other things that can be Lolita, depending on what your personality is. So what you just described is someone that's typically described as a lifestyle Lolita.
Okay.
Who is
what's
really
that?
A lifestyle Lolita is someone who likes to incorporate Lolita fashion throughout their entire life, so through their activities, through their actions, through their personality, whereas some Lolitas simply are themselves and dress in the fashion.
Okay, I don't think I'm a lifestyle. I know.
Neither am I.
So, what do you feel? Well, I guess this whole event really is about like the culture, costume. What is it that really sets Lolita apart from being a costume? Because I know to people who are seeing this for the first time, like, are probably going to assume that this is a costume. What is it that kind of differentiates it and makes it a fashion?
I think personally what makes it different from a costume is for a lot of Lolitas, to wear Lolita is to be yourself, but to wear a costume is to be something else. And I think maybe that's the big difference between costume and the culture of Lolita.
Yeah, is it like, I don't know, is it, is it more of like artistic expression? Like how about in Japan? Is it more of like a rebellion? Is it artistic expression? Or where is it coming from there? Is it different from here?
In Japan, I think a lot of the times Lolita fashion is also confused with cosplay. I see that often. But of course, Lolita got its start in Japan, and it's Japan's own interpretation of the Rococo fashion, so I think it's more renowned and more established in Japan as a fashion.
Well, is it like more mainstream in Japan? Does it come across... In Japan, is it like a little less of a subculture than it is here?
So desu ne, shinto shitsutsu wa aru n desu kedo, mada mada dewa arimasu.
Yes, I think it's starting to be that way, a little more mainstream, but we have ways to go.
Is it something that you see more just like in, is it similar to like how in punk rock in the United States or in London, UK, it was fashion, and it was a culture, and it was music. Is it the same way in Japan, or is it more so of just fashion and culture?
Lolita fashion wa daitai 90 nendai gurai kara hajimatta fashion de 2004 nen de daitai 10 nen mae nan desu kedo Shimotsuma Monogatari toyu eiga de dai breiku shita fashion nanode tokuni ongaku teiu mono ga
So Lolita fashion got its start in the 90s, and of course with the film, as many of you know, Shimotsuma Monogatari or Kamikaze Girls here, that was actually the film that sort of made Lolita fashion go mainstream in 2004. So, but it hasn't really reached that level where it influences music yet.
Oh, okay. Well, I know that we were talking backstage for like a minute earlier, and I know that you've been involved in the Lolita community for a, like kind of a long time.
Yeah, like 11 years.
So how have you seen it change in that time? Like what's going on now, what's going on then?
I think it's definitely become more of a subculture. That used to be one of the biggest, I remember in like 2002, one of the biggest arguments was it can't be a subculture because it's just clothes. And that's obviously changed. I feel like we have a lot of subcultural elements. We have kind of our own language, at least in the Western community. We have like specific terms we use.
Like what?
JSK.
OK, wait.
OTT.
Yeah.
Like.
OTT, that's over
yeah,
the top.
Over
that's
the top.
Me.
Yeah, yeah, you. Like the terms for the brands. And we use a lot of Japanese terms sometimes.
Okay.
Like we do sometimes use Mirando and. Chan is a word we add to things a lot, even though we don't have to, but we've definitely kind of adopted a lot of things to make Lolita more about like the people wearing it than just the things that they're wearing.
Right. In Japan, Misako, is it, is it similar? Do you guys, do people in the community there adopt English terms into it? Being that Rococo, the Rococo era is like a Western-based style, is there the same kind of crossover that there is here?
あ、それはすごくあります。映画もあのマリー・アントワネットという映画がすごくあのロリータさん好きな映画でもあるし、あと今流行ってるのがロリータという英語で書いてあるバッジとかもつけてること、女の子もすごく多いのでロリータを英語であの書くのがすごく可愛いと今されています。
Yeah, definitely. I would say so. And for instance, Marie Antoinette, the film, was a huge, very, very popular among the Lolita community. So, and also one of the very popular thing right now is the sort of the pin badge that says Lolita in English. So to write Lolita in English script is very popular and it's considered very kawaii.
This really.
I also wanted to know, like, have you seen, I know that you travel all over the world, have you seen differences in Lolita culture in the different places that you've gone to?
そうですね、あのファッションで自由じゃない国もあったりするのであのそれぞれ違いはありますけどアメリカはかなり派手な派手に着こなしているデコロリのファッションの方が多いなという印象があります。
Yes, I do see a difference according to a specific country. And of course, certain countries don't have the freedom to dress the way you want, for instance. But in the US, I see a lot of bright colors, a lot of décolleries are the most popular, it seems to me.
I know also you do a lot of surveying, you like collect all this data, which is fascinating. Have you seen any like trends that have like maybe come and gone? Like, tell me a little bit about, like the evolution of the fashion.
The biggest one, since you're talking about OTT suite, is that OTT suite kind of turned down its popularity probably around 2008, earlier, like 10, maybe 10. Yeah. But it started to lose its popularity, and now the popular style that's coming out is more of a classic look. Lolitas really are enjoying a more mature and toned down colors. Although sweet is still very a popular entity, classic is very much more popular.
Maybe that has to do with people like who have been in it for a while growing up.
And I think that's it. Yeah. Like a lot of people who were really big into the OTT trend were in their early 20s. Mm. When they first got into it, and now they're kind of like in their mid to late 20s, and they're like, maybe I don't want to dress like this anymore. But I've noticed that it's still as over the top as the top suite was a lot of times. Like for years, classic used to be the toned down style. It was
quiet.
It was very quiet. it was simple. But now it's just as opulent and over the top as the over the top suite Lolita is, and it's like huge bonnets, just corsages. And, just as poofy dresses.
Just the bonnets.
No.
They're so cute.
Kawaii desu.
Talking about the age demographics, the pool that I poll is obviously incredibly small in comparison to the entire Lolita community. But from the group that I've pulled from, the age group has really started a trend from 18 to 24 to more of a 24 to 27. And I think it is because of, like you said, this large group of Lolitas are getting older. And as you get older, you start getting into certain constraints like work and family, and suddenly sweet Lolita might not be as practical as maybe a gothic or a classic.
Yes, I definitely could not go to work wearing.
Yeah, like one of the things about like the classic Lolita, even if it's over the top, you can still tone it down. But like with a sweet Lolita dress, you kind of it's always gonna be really sweet.
So have you always been more into the classic look? I mean, how did you guys get into it? I know that you model, but how did you guys find out about it? How did you get in? How does everyone else get into the club? Tell me about it.
Strict process.
Yeah. I got into it a long time ago by seeing pictures online, and this was back in the days of J-rock was really big in the U.S. It kind of jumped from Japan to the U.S. goth scene, and we saw like gothic Lolita through that, and I kind of, that's how I sort of got into it with Malice Miser. So I was really big into to gothic Lolita, and I still am, but.
So before, Misako was saying that it's not in Japan, there's not as much of like a crossover with music and fashion, but it kind of sounds like here it does have that aspect to it.
Back then I feel like it used to be.
Yeah.
Really back then, like 2001 to 2003, when it came over with the goth scene,
right.
Like, and when gothic Lolita was really big, because there were a lot more people in the Western gothic subculture who were into Lolita as another extension of their gothic style, but now it's not so much. There are Lolitas who are in bands who do Lolita-styled music.
That's awesome.
I know.
Yeah, that's definitely been the crossover, is more Lolitas in musical acts of some kind, either singing or bands or whatever. That's definitely been kind of a surge recently in the last few years.
But it's more of a, like, I'm a Lolita and I do this too, sort of thing.
Rather than, like, I'm a Lolita band.
Yeah.
How did you get involved in Lolita?
Oh, I have a sad story.
Oh, no.
it's not that sad. I bought a very cheaply made dress from a costume store back in 2006, 2007, and I thought it was really cute, and I wore it, and someone recognized the dress from Bodyline. And they said,
"What
to
is
me,
why is everyone laughing?"
It was a Wa Lolita dress for anybody's reference. And yeah, I know.
Wait, what's Bodyline?
Bodyline is another brand that you can find in Japan. It's a little bit more inexpensive than the other brands that are available.
Okay.
But the dress that I bought, someone recognized me and asked if I was a Lolita, and I went, "Huh?" I had no idea what that was. So from then on, I met several people in the community and. Here I am.
Yay. Misako, how did you first get into Lolita? Was it through modeling? Was it through friends? How did you first hear about it?
私は読者モデルになったのがきっかけで、雑誌で聞いたのがきっかけでした。
So what started it all for me was that I was the so-called doksha model or reader model for Kara. So that's how I got into Lolita and I was introduced.
まだそんなに街中にロリータさんがいなかったので街中で見るっていうこともなかったですし原宿にも1店舗ぐらいしかお店がなかったので、はい、雑誌で来たのがきっかけです。
So for me, my first exposure was through a magazine shoot because at that time you didn't see a lot of Lolitas out in the streets and I think there was only about one store in Harajuku at the time, so it was really through the fashion shoot that I got to know.
That's so cool.Is there, in Japan, is it, I know here, Lolita is pretty much based around the online community. I mean, that's where everyone meets each other, that's where everyone talks. Is it similar in Japan? Is it based online or is it more in real life?
コミュニティでそのオンラインでもちろん会うこともありますし、あと一緒にお買い物とかお茶会とかする女の子たちのお友達もいるので、半々ぐらいじゃないかなと。
I would say it's half and half. Of course, there's an online community where we get together that way, but we also go on tea parties together or shopping together. So I would say half and half.
So this was something that I was noticing when I was researching for the event. I found EGL on LiveJournal, the Elegant Gothic Lolita Community, which was fabulous and so supportive, and it was really excellent to see a lot of, not just discussion about fashion going on there, but, you know, girls helping each other, you know, with personal problems and helping them build their confidence, and girls telling stories about how, like, being...part of the community and going to meets, how it really changed how they felt about themselves. At the same time, I also found another site that I won't name what it was, but it was a little, it made me really nervous to come here, honestly, like not being part of the community. It had some, you know, anonymous messages people would send in, and you know, random photos pulled, I guess, from online. I just want to know how do we tell people like me, or I don't know if anyone else here is interested, like, how do you get involved, and you know, what do you say about, like, you know, the kind of like negative comments that are going around on sites like that? Like, is that what the community is like?
I personally don't think so. A lot of the things you see in anonymous confessions are not representative of most Lolitas. I honestly have, I don't think I've, in 11, 12 years, I don't think I've ever met, like, the stereotypical Lolita on one of those sites sending in confessions. I feel like a lot of it is people are voicing their fears or, like, one-time bad experiences, and it's really not a good example of Lolita communities. It's just, it's kind of fear, honestly.
Yeah.
So. The best example of a Lolita community is to talk to a real-life Lolita yourself. Okay. By meeting a Lolita in person, and obviously there's evil and terrible people throughout the world, so hopefully you don't meet that one bad person, but for the most part, you're going to meet a Lolita, and they're going to be really excited to tell you, this is our fashion, this is our culture, this is what we do, this is how you shop, this is how you go here, and this is how you go there. At least I know, and yeah. Speaking for me and Caro, we both are very like, come on down.
Yeah,
like, join us in this crazy thing. They really want to do this.
I think a lot of people get the idea from online communities that, like, the streets are littered with Lolitas who are going to judge you, and that's definitely not the case. Like, I get really excited when someone recognizes that I'm wearing Lolita, like, even if they're in jeans and t-shirt, and it's like a bonding moment with a stranger. It's like, you know about this too, and it's like, isn't it great? And it's like, I personally want to be like, oh, like, tell me about, like, what dresses you want to buy, and it's silly, but I really... enjoy that.
I really was like so nervous about like people being like, you don't know it, you're not doing it right. And but not like I also coming here, meeting you guys, everyone's so sweet. And I ran and took a couple people like in the hallway while I was like getting ready and like panicking. But everyone was really nice. So you know, maybe
at the end of the day, we're so small and insignificant in the scope of the world that it would be silly for someone to leave someone out. So if you're interested and you talk to someone, the first thing we're going to do is try to recruit you for the Lolita Army.
Well, I know that we're definitely having a reception after the event is done, and there's more event to happen. So everyone should definitely, like, talk to everyone else. Everyone should make friends. And I think we're going to open it up right now for questions and answers with the audience. There are staff members that have microphones that are on either, I think, right back over there, microphone. So raise your hand if you have a question, and then someone will bring you a microphone. Yes, sir.
Obviously, I'm not a Lolita, but...
Are you sure? I got a bow right here for you.
So I have a question. What do your parents think about it?
And, I mean...
And what does your boyfriend think about it?
Let me answer that question. Husband, can you stand up, please? Right here. Right here. As you can see, my husband is not a Lolita. My husband and I are actually direct opposites. He is not interested in Lolita, has no interest, but I will say that our relationship, he is extremely passionate about the fact that I'm extremely passionate about my fashion, and he hopefully loves me for me. So I think in terms of relationships, it's all about finding someone that's very understanding and supportive of you, because at the end of the day, that's what love's all about. Sorry, babe. you want to do?
Oh, I kind of have been dressing really strangely ever since my parents first let me how to dress myself. So when I first showed them like these frilly dresses, it was the baby Starshine Bright sight was one of the first sights I saw. And I remember being like, Mom, I want to wear these. And she was like, well, at least you don't want to wear black anymore. So
happy it was something different.
I know, but then, you know, I went straight to the black dresses after that. So my parents are fine with it. They don't care. Like, I'm not making them wear it, so yeah. Why would they care? My boyfriend I actually met at a Lolita meetup, so he's just as familiar with it as I am. Like, yeah, I know. He can get into, like, conversations about body line with anyone. He knows, like, half the Lolitas in my community, too. So he's fine with it. My parents are fine with it. All my friends are fine with it.
What do your parents think?
そうですね。私自身はすごく中学生の時とかは目立たない女の子で地味な女の子だったんですけど、ロリータファッションによって世界中の方とお友達になれたりとか、ファンの方と交流できたり、可愛いって言ってもらえることによって自信が持てたので、自分の人生を変えてくれたファッションなので、すごく両親も賛成してます。
So when I was in middle school, I did not stand out at all. I was always in subdued colors and you know things like that. So, but through Lolita fashion, I got to know so many fans and I made friends all over the world. And they told me what I'm wearing is kawaii, and that really helped me, gain my confidence back. So it was a life changing experience for me. Lolita fashion really changed my life. So in that sense, I think my parents are very grateful.
Any other questions? Oh, someone's coming over.
There we go. It's really loud. Anyway, do you guys have a favorite?
Am I so good?
Oh, do you guys have a favorite print and brand?
Oh, there's so many.
My favorite brand is definitely Baby the Star Shine Bright. They were the first brand I really got into. A lot of my, I'm not wearing it today, but a lot of my closet is, of course, yeah, is Baby the Star Shine Bright. They're definitely one of my favorite brands, but my favorite prints is actually, I really like the old school Angelic Pretty Screen prints from like 2002, I think, to 2004. Secret Garden is one of my favorite prints.
Cute.
Yeah.
For me, I am gonna go with Chantilly. And two reasons why I love Chantilly. One, I don't know if you can tell, but I'm a little bit larger than the typical Lolita. So Chantilly is very, very, very forgiving in terms of sizing. And every dress that they make, this is actually, this is not something I would typically wear, but I really wanted to wear mint. But typically I'm in black, so Chantilly has a lot of gothic prints that I absolutely love, especially their metallics on black are gorgeous to me, and I want to own them all, but I'm very, don't have that much money.
私はベイビーが一番好きで、で去年ベイビーと私でコラボをして出した自分でデザインしたお洋服でピンクと赤のリボンのお洋服があるんですけど、それが一番好きです。
So of course I like Baby the most, and we did a collaboration with Baby. I did a collaboration with Baby last year, and I created this ensemble with a pink and red ribbon. So I think that's my favorite right now.
Yeah. Anybody else? Questions. Oh, there's so many hands. There, in the back, black shirt. You, yeah. Hi.
So my question goes to kind of the first question. Well, I was inspired by the first question, but is there a space for men in the Lolita community?
Oh, I meant to ask that earlier. Good question.
Also, going off that, if there is or isn't, how do you think Lolita is a further expression of femininity?
Excellent question.
Me or you?
There's definitely a space for men in kind of both sides of the coin for Lolita. One of the most famous Lolitas is probably Mana of Malice Mizer, and he's a man. He's popularized the Gothic Lolita movement in the West, probably. And there are a lot of men who wear Lolita as the way a woman would wear it. And then there's also kind of the male equivalent of boy style, which is like, it's similar to Lolita, except for it's like pants. It's a very princely fashion, and there are ways for men to get involved with Lolita.
Basically, the gentleman that goes along with the Lolita. It's pretty much, there's a lot of different specifics that I could go into. I mean, there's boy style, dandy, aristocrat. They have a lot of specifics. I just don't, I don't know enough about the men, but there's definitely a spot for them, either as the Lolita or as our nice
chaperone
on the side.
Yeah, I was definitely interested when I was doing some research, like for this event, on like, I was thinking a lot about like the feminine aspects of it, and especially that goes along with the culture and not just with like, you know, obviously like the bows and the frills, but it really is like, I really enjoy wearing it because it makes me feel extremely feminine, and it makes me feel kind of fabulous also, which I think everyone needs to have a little bit of that. Do we have time for more questions? There's another one up front. God, everyone looks so good. Like, seriously.
So I have a question kind of for everybody. What is your favorite, like, most positive Lolita memory? Like, something that just kind of made you glow inside and you felt so happy that someone actually understood.
Can I go?
Yeah, go ahead. I'm still thinking.
Actually, I don't know if it made me feel positive as a Lolita, but it definitely made me feel like I was bringing happiness to the world. Was when there was a little girl who was about 4 years old, and I was wearing, I have a red version of this dress with white lace, and she came up to me and she asked me if I was Little Red Riding Hood, and I said, well, because she was four, I said, yes, yes, I am. And I'm not going to break a four-year-old's heart. She said, oh, can you please, like, I'll play with you when I get home, because she had a doll of Little Red Hood. And I said, I'll see you there. And her mom was like, thank you. And I was like, it was wonderful. And if my outfit alone just brought that much happiness, it's like, it's so worth it. Worth all the weird looks and what is that? So, oh, thank you. So.
I can't top that.
Yeah, that was pretty good.
All right, maybe someone else. Let's get someone in the back. Lovely, over there, hat, pink. Excellent. Yes.
Hi, this is for anyone who actually has ever flown in Lolita, mainly probably Misako-san. Do you wear a petticoat when you fly? Like a hikoki no naka ni petticoat, kabocha pants toka, ironna paniya toka, kyo kana, haiteru ka dou ka.
あ、今日ですか?今日ですか?今日かどうか。普通にロリータで、なんか、なんか帰着して、でもなんかパニアはちょっとお邪魔だと思っていますので、なんか飛行機でなんか着ようかどうか。あ、パニアですか?そうですね。あ、パニアは、あ、一人で来ます。
夏とかすごく暑い時はちょっと1枚とかにしちゃう時はあるんですけど、でも基本的にやっぱりパニエはいっぱい入ってた方が柄が可愛く見えるので、頑張っていっぱい履くようにしてます。So,
of course, in the summer when it's really hot, our one layer is enough probably to keep cool. But fundamentally speaking, I would advise wearing a lot of layers of paniya because it really makes the whole ensemble come together and stand out. So, yeah. But,
like, even in a plane is what I'm saying.
She's, like, basically always looking fabulous.
Well,
そう、今日も、今日着いたんですけど、着てきましたし、さっきのお話じゃないですけど、小さい子にシンデレラかって言われました。
Yes, I actually arrived today, and I was on a plane in this ensemble, and like your story, a little girl did come up to me and asked if I was Cinderella.
When I like got here, like I arrived on time. It wasn't like too late or anything. But she was like already done, and I was like, "What? Like, how did you get dressed so fast?" But it's because she came on the plane.
I'll be oddball out. I take my petty off. Only because the U.S. customs are very strict, and if you have a petticoat on, you're immediately sent to the "we need to check you out personally" area. So I've traveled several times, and each time I don't, because I don't want to get checked out personally.
Yeah, no. Do you have any other questions going on? Over here on the end, in this lovely pink wig. Raise your hand. Yeah.
Hi.
Hi.
Okay. I'm sure some of you saw the TLC, My Strange Addiction. You know, about the living dolls. Mm-hmm. How did you guys feel about Lolita being considered, you know, living dolls and under My Strange Addiction?
Now I know what she's talking about.
Yeah. I have mixed feelings about it. It obviously is not a representative of Lolita in any way whatsoever. But they also didn't really use the word Lolita. I don't know, there have been reports of people after that came out, like being asked by strangers, like, oh, are you doing that living doll thing? But I don't know, it doesn't really bother me because it's like, no, I'm not. And then in 3 months, the world's gonna forget about it. So I don't know, pretty ambivalent towards it.
Yeah, I think because they didn't use the word Lolita so much, I only watched the last half, and from the last half there was like, I think I heard it like twice, and most of the time they were saying they were dolls. So it didn't really bother me as much either. But I will say the whole bloomers to go get a job thing really creeped me out. But other than that, yeah, that's underwear. It shouldn't, not pants. But.
I think we have time for a couple more questions. Gentleman right here. Someone will bring you a microphone. Yeah.
Welcome to New York, anyway.
Thank you.
I'm wondering how many sets of clothing, how many changes of clothing do you typically have in your closet? And what do you, Lolita clothing, that is, and what do you do for special holidays? Halloween? So do you dress on a Halloween special Lolita? Christmas time, do you have special setups for these holidays as opposed to everyday wear?
I have about 100 costumes,
that sounds nice.
Items. Yeah.
で、ロリータファッションはまあ、いろんな柄があるように、今バレンタインシーズンなのでチョコレート柄だったり、クリスマスはツリー柄だったり、ハロウィンだったらちょっと魔女っぽい柄だったり、いっぱいいろんなブランドからいろんなのが出ているので、そういう意味でも季節感を感じながらファッションを楽しむことができるものだと思います。
So the Lolita fashion, of course, have a variety of patterns available. And right now it's the Valentine season, so it's the chocolate pattern. And during Christmas, it may be the tree pattern, or Halloween, and almost maybe a little bit of a witchy pattern. So the variety of brands do come out with a seasonal pattern. So in that sense, I think you can enjoy Lolita fashion throughout the year.
Awesome. There's a question right behind you. This little cutie in the little hat. Oh, I can't get over how good everyone looks.
Kawaii desu.
Hi guys, hi everyone.
Hi.
Obviously Lolita's always changing and evolving, so do you guys have any predictions on upcoming trends for 2014?
I don't know. I think classic is gonna keep rising. I've noticed a lot of, in the past maybe year and a half, a lot of different ideas in the way the silhouette has gone, including lengths. Like with the popularity of Juliet and Justine, there's been a lot of longer dresses that are not as full. And I can kind of see this trend, like maybe sticking in Lolita a little bit more as people want to experiment more with silhouettes and lengths.
What about in Japan? Is it, are the trends like on the same time as they are here? Is everything being released at the same time? I know like, you know, sometimes fashion trends are coming at different times in different areas.
いやもう本当におっしゃる通りだと思います。今本当にクラシカルロリータが日本でも人気があって、長めのドレスが人気があるっていう、本当にまさに
You got it exactly right. It's exactly as you say. I think classical Lolita in Japan are very popular. The longer dresses definitely in Japan as well.
All right, awesome. I think we have time for a couple more. Right here in the front, blue shirt, woman right here. You, yes. Yeah.
Thank you very much. I'm enjoying all the fantastic costume. Lolita fashion. I have a question about age limit for Lolita fashion. Would you be wearing those Lolita fashion in 15 years, 20 years? Would you face the age limit in the future?
I plan on looking good for like, you know, well, into like my 80s or so. Like, I'm definitely gonna be a glamour nanny for sure.
I know personally, I have a dress that I'd like to be buried in. Personally.
All right, I think we're gonna move on with the event. We have an excellent fashion show happening. But everybody, please stay and come to the reception afterwards, and let's all keep talking about everything, and let's like ask more questions, let's hang out, and let's have like cookies and wine and stuff. So yes, fashion show. Please, huge round of applause for these fabulous women. Original design by Baby the Star Shine Bright and is part of the Strawberry Days series. It is highlighted by a sailor blouse and cute little red tea party shoes. From Baby the Star Shine Bright features a sparkly and striped jumper skirt. It is accompanied by a super cute flower headband and wand to evoke the image of a spring fairy.
This coordinate was released last year by Baby the Star Shine Bright at its floating tea party. It is a one-piece dress that features a Victorian soiree pattern with plenty of petticoats to give the dress its classic cupcakes away. Similar to the print on it, it evokes the image of a princess going to a ball. Another dress by Baby the Star Shine Bright, titled Wedding Dress from the Maiden from the Star. Love it. This outfit clearly makes great use of Baby's original lace. This is a dark one piece by Alice and the Pirates titled Lost Paradise. This print depicts classical paintings of Adam and Eve in gilded frames and apple trees with menacing snakes winding up the trunks with a lovely A-line shape. This dashing ensemble features an embellished tailcoat with corset lacing and trousers paired with a charming top hat. Thank you. in our final piece for the evening. With an asymmetrical bustle, high-waisted corset, and a jeweled bodice, this outfit is the epitome of Alice and the Pirates' Gothic Lolita style. The red rose and the headband on a fabulous cane are striking touches to the outfit's design. Let's get a big round of applause for all of our models, all the fabulous fashions, all the panelists. Work the room, ladies.
How was the fashion show, everybody?
ロリータファッションの魅力がいっぱい詰まった今回のイベントだったと思います。ありがとうございました。
I think this event was full of all the charms of the Lolita fashion. Thank you so much.
このロリータファッションのハウトゥー本を私が3月にマイナビ出版さんから出すので、海外ではアマゾンでも買えるのでぜひよかったらロリータファッションについて知りたい方はそちらもチェックしてみてください。
So, I will be publishing a manual for a Lolita fashion how-to book soon, so it'll be available through Amazon in the States, so I hope you'll get to see that and purchase one.
Thank you so much.